3-4-34, a number that has become a part of you.
One that you will always put on before your own. It's a representation, something to hold on to.
34 is a memory with infinite emotions.
Taking the field at Marist, or your life as a whole will never be the same.
Winning or losing, it's how you played for him.
Fill your heart with EC34, it's a part of you.
Eddie is a brother, he is family.
This year is just a big year to, you know, remember Ed through each game, through every practice, through every day, because you knew that, you know, if Ed was here, he'd give it all he had, and he'd leave everything out there for you personally and for, you know, all of his friends and teammates, because Ed, that's the kind of guy Ed was.
I'm thankful for that I got to know him for even just that short amount of time, and I'm just happy that he, you know, wanted to be my friend. I'm actually honored by that.
Like, just instantly, you know, he just became one of my best friends, like, just like that.
He's doing a lot of good things through his legacy, and I'm truly honored to be a part of it.
Nobody forgets about him. Anytime I see the number 34, Eddie Coombs all the way.
I never really told anybody outside this team what Ed meant to me, all right? What Ed meant to me was someone beyond, he made me want to be a better person. But when I started talking about him as a player, I said he was that one guy that made the first play of every game with pure hustle. He was the guy that set the example and the tone, and he was only a freshman.
When I think about a guy like Eddie, the first thing that comes to mind is the type of player that through his play made every single person on the field better. And it wasn't just for one game, it was for every single game that he was able to play.
The main thing with Ed is he was my wingman on the faceoffs. He's always there to get ground balls. I enjoyed playing with him because he was so fast. He'd always just be there to scoop up the ground ball when I put it out to him. And to speak to what Ed did as a teammate, he wasn't the guy that scored 4 or 5 goals a game. We didn't look for him for offensive production, and he wasn't the big star always getting the headlines. But Ed did the small things, and getting ground balls in games and stuff like that. And it was overtime, and it was a tie game, first faceoff, and I remember popping the ball forward, scooping it up, and I just remember throwing the ball to Connor. And Connor made like a move, dodged, shot, and scored. And I really didn't get any recognition for the play, but I remember Ed, everyone else kind of sprinted to Connor, and Ed came running out to me, jumped on my back, and he goes to me, he's like, that's all you. He goes, you know, Connor got the points for that. He goes, but you created that with your thing. And that's the kind of guy Eddie was. He recognized the small plays.
He was the first person coming over to you on the sideline, patting you on the head, saying good job. He never cared about any individual accolades. It was all about the team, and that's real tough coming from a freshman. Eddie had the most heart on the field, and I think he truly was one of the best teammates I've ever played with.
Yeah, he loved everybody on this team. He was a huge part of this team, and even as a freshman, he was only on it for a year. And it says a lot that, you know, guys that are seniors and that were juniors, you know, that he meant so much to us and to everybody. I had the pleasure of being the locker right next to him and being his bus partner to every away game. So the two of us really, you know, talked a lot and shared a lot of things, and he didn't hold anything back and really let me into his life, and that meant a lot to me. And I know it meant a lot to everybody on this team. If I could say one word about Eddie, it would be what's over his locker, which is heart. He cared about everybody on this team. He tried, he gave 100% effort every time he was out there at practice. In every game, he would be dog tired at the end of the game on the bus coming home, and that's just because he laid it all out on the line, not for himself, not for, you know, personal stats, but for the team. And I think that says a lot about who he is and how he was brought up by his parents. And it was a pleasure and an honor to have known Ed, even if it was only for a year, because he was such an amazing person.
I guess when I think about Eddie, I remember after the Jacksonville game, we won the game in overtime, and I just remember Eddie running over to me and jumping on me, and he hit me so hard it gave me a headache. I think he might have given me a concussion because he was just so excited that we won the game. And I just remember Eddie giving it everything he had when he played lacrosse and going out and just, he was just the best kid you could hope to have as a teammate and a really good friend, and he was a lot of fun to be around too. He made everyone feel good about themselves.
Watching Eddie play on the field was one of the coolest things that I've gotten to see here. The way that he played and moved on the field, he just had a distinct ability to go all out every play, all the time. It's like he never got tired.
As a teammate, you couldn't really ask for much more. He's an amazing competitor, an amazing person, and he would give his all no matter what on the field. He was injured the whole second half of the year last year, and I played the same position as him, and so like 5 games left in the season, he got hurt, I think, somewhere around there, and he was really struggling through those games sometimes, but he would refuse to come out. He'd come out, get his leg rewrapped, go back in again. I'd be standing there like, Ed, you want me to go in for you? And he'd be like, nah, I got it. Then come back out 5 minutes later, get rewrapped, go back in. He was a warrior on the field. And that's what Eddie did. He never gave up. He never quit. He was always there and ready to give it his all no matter what.
The last playing memory I had with him was when we played Detroit in the semifinals of the MAC championship. And he was hurt so bad that I had to carry him off the field, and we were crying together because it just hurt so much emotionally, and he was hurt so much physically that it was just so much to deal with. And, you know, I really wish that wasn't the last playing memory I had with him. I wish there were more opportunities, but that's just what he embodied. He embodied heart, hustle, the greatest attitude I think I've ever played with. You know, if he was here, there's no doubt that he probably would have been up for being a captain as a sophomore or junior for how mature he was. He pushed himself harder. He pushed anyone else on this team harder than anyone else could have even asked. And to be so mature at such a young age and put himself through so much and, you know, to throw himself on the line through pain emotionally, physically, to the point where he couldn't even walk, just meant so much to everyone on this team. And, you know, we miss him every day.
A lot of things stick out to me about Ed on the field, but off the field, he knew everybody better than you thought he did. I remember he was talking to me about Pat Wall, one of our juniors, kind of our team comedian, loud, outgoing. And he came up to me and he was like, Pat Wall is real funny. You know, he's loud, he's out there. But you're funny too. You're not as loud as he is. And I didn't know he knew that about me. It just goes to show the kind of kid he was and the kind of relationships we built.
I met him, and I knew this kid was going to be special right away. Everyone was drawn to him from the get-go. He's just someone you want to be around constantly. You know, he lit up the room with his smile, and as soon as you saw him, you just got happy.
I think that the number one thing that I'm going to always take with me from Eddie is that no matter how long you know someone, they can definitely make a big impact in your life. Eddie and I came in together here at Marist, and we only knew each other for the 1 year, but I can definitely say that he's someone that will leave an impact on me, and his dedication and drive and passion are something that I definitely will take with me throughout my time.
I'll never forget the day Ed called to tell me he was committing to Marist College, and I was actually more nervous than he was, I think. You know, when he called, I remember pacing back and forth. I had missed his call, so I was waiting to call him back, and I was very nervous because he was a very highly touted recruit for us, that he was going to tell me he was going somewhere else. And actually, when I called, I could hear his dad in the background, you know, screaming how excited he was. And Eddie told me in his deep voice, you know, I'm coming to Marist, coach, and I'll never forget that. You know, that was a phone call that changed my life. And, you know, through the rest of that year, I got to communicate with Ed and talk to him about what we were planning on building here at Marist College and within this lacrosse family. And he was a big piece of that, you know, what we were planning on doing here.
My greatest memory with Eddie was probably at the Albany game. It was our first defeat, or first win ever against a ranked team. And it was his first ever, he was his first and only career goal. And after he scored, we were just so happy for him. You know, he's one of our best players. And after he scored, we were so happy for him. And at the tailgate, you just see how happy his dad was. His dad came to every single game. And after seeing that, seeing his son score, he was just so happy.
I just want to say one thing to you guys. You guys mean the world to me and my family. Today, the middle school came by and dropped off a check for $1,000. All of the kids in the middle school sold soft pretzels for Edwards Foundation. And on the poster, it said, Marist 34. Play fast, live slow. It's more than you. It's a whole community. It's a whole community. And you're helping it heal. And I thank you for it.
Love you, Pop. Gotta
love you. Keep it up.
Love you, Mr. Coombs.
It's effort. Just give effort. Give effort. Ground balls is effort. Turnovers are effort. That's heart. Make it happen.
Yeah! It starts with every man in this huddle. Every man in this huddle is a part of this family. I hope you alums know how much we talk about you guys, too. You guys started this thing, okay? And we're gonna finish it for Eric Coombs, and his family, and Eddie Coombs.
Hell yeah, man!
Yeah, boy!
Yeah, man! Let's make this the loudest one of the year. We got a couple extra bodies. Coombs on three. One, two, three!
Eddie is a brother.
The perfect teammate.
Family.
Inspiration.
Always watching us.
Our heartbeat.
He was one of the truest people I've ever met. Legendary.
Eddie was my brother.
He was family right away.
So he's my inspiration every day.
Me, he's perfect.
He's my inspiration on and off the field.
Eddie is fresh.
Best friend.
He's an amazing person.
Eddie is perfect.
My inspiration.
He's my teammate.
Motivation, the hero.
Just everything. Family.
Our inspiration. He was what we play for.
He's my guardian angel.
Eddie is a warrior. He's one of a kind. Genuine. And he's always going to be the brightest star in my sky. I miss him a lot. Love him a lot. Can't wait to see him again.
Somebody